In order to better understand the power quality and protection aspects of microgrids in the coming weeks, here we shortly introduce the sequences of the unbalanced three-phase AC systems. On top of this, in order to better understand how local control using phase-locked loop is implemented in microgrids, we take a step back to address the reference transformations in the three-phase systems. We address the following three learning objectives. Firstly, what are the positive, negative, zero sequences for the unbalanced three-phase systems? Secondly, what is the alpha-beta transformation and when it is used? Thirdly, what is the phase-locked loop? Three-phase AC microgrids are not always operated with balanced voltage and currents. Conversely, they are operating mostly under unbalanced conditions. As an example, the connection of the large-scale single-phase photovoltaics with different numbers of units across three phases will eventually create large imbalances. At the demand side, the uneven connection of loads can also create unbalanced flows. In order to more straightforwardly represent three-phase imbalances, they are typically transformed and divided into three positive, negative, and zero sequences. On the one hand, the positive sequence is fully in phase with the three-phase system. Note that if the three-phase system is totally balanced, then the negative and zero sequences are equal to zero. On the other hand, the negative sequences has the difference of 180 degrees compared to the positive system. During the unbalanced events, like single-phase or two-phase faults to the ground, the negative sequence gains a value. Finally, we introduce the zero sequence that has the same phase for all three lines of A, B, and C. If these three sequences are known, then it is possible to obtain the actual three-phase values as it is shown in the figure. The current of each line, like line A, is obtained by the sum of the current of the zero sequence, the current of the positive sequence, and the current of the negative sequence. In a three-phase system, each line has a phase difference of 120 degrees from the other ones. To transform from a three-phase system to three positive, negative, and zero sequences, matrix A is introduced and used as shown in the slide. If the phase difference is zero, then one is placed in the element of the matrix. If the phase difference between two lines is 120 degrees, then A is placed. And if the phase difference is 220 degrees, then a square A is put in the matrix. If the values of the currents of lines A, B, and C are known, then three sequences can be obtained multiplying the A matrix. Note that at the values of the negative and zero sequence determine to what extent the three-phase system is actually unbalanced. In order to facilitate the calculations of three-phase systems, various reference frame representations can be introduced, like alpha-beta transformation, which has a static frame, and the DQ transformation, which has a rotating frame. Here we address the alpha-beta transformation, which is a mathematical transformation to make the analysis of three-phase circuits simpler. It is also called Clark transformation. One very useful application of the alpha-beta transformation is the generation of the reference signal that is used for the space vector modulation control of three-phase inverters that we will discuss in the future videos. We can transform a vector X representing the voltage in three-phase A, B, C reference into an alpha-beta stationary frame. In this case, we have two components, X alpha and X beta, instead of three lines. Sometimes a third dimension is added and the resulting frame becomes the alpha beta zero frame. If the three-phase system is balanced, then the zero component of the alpha beta zero frame is actually a zero element. In some applications, such as electrical machines, it is useful to transform three-phase voltages and currents to the rotating frame, the so-called DQ frame. Let's focus now on the mathematical formulation of the alpha beta transformation. To go from a three-phase element vector in the ABC framework to a two-element vector in the alpha beta framework, we must multiply it by the transformation matrix, which is shown in the formula. A factor 2 divided by 3 is added, so the active and reactive power calculations give the same result in both ABC and alpha beta frameworks. The transformation is then called power invariant. To conduct these transformations, we would need to obtain the phase angle. To do so, a phase lock loop, or PLL, is used to generate an output signal whose phase is in related to the phase of an input signal. There are different types of PLL. The simplest one is an electronic circuit consisting of a variable frequency oscillator and a phase detector in a feedback loop. The oscillator generates a periodic signal, and the phase detector compares the phase of the signal with the phase of the input periodic signal, adjusting the oscillator to keep the phases matched. A low-pass filter is always included in order to cancel out the high-frequency noise in the signal that could interfere with the comparator. Note that the input and output phases are maintained in the lock step, meaning to keep the input and output frequencies the same. Phase-lock loops are widely employed in the radio, telecommunications, computers, and other electronic applications. In this video, first we addressed three sequences of unbalanced microgrids, and then introduced in more detail alpha-beta transformations for a three-phase system. We also introduced the phase-lock loop, which is an important block of all electronically interfaced DG units that we will use in the future videos.